Hi, I'm Sarah Chisnell, staff scientist here at Science North in the Discovery Theater. And I thought due to the weather, we might talk about things that are cold. And I thought, what's colder than liquid nitrogen? Liquid nitrogen is a liquid at minus 196 degrees Celsius. And you thought it was cold today at minus 27 degrees Celsius. Well, what we have for you is a little bit about particle theory, a little bit about what happens to particles when it gets really, really cold. So here I have a dewar of liquid nitrogen. You can see it's boiling. It's hot out here to liquid nitrogen. It's turning into a gas. It's boiling away quite fast. It would boil away a little bit faster if we were inside, but still pretty fast even though we're outside. And what I want to see is what happens to gas. We're going to start with gas. So I have these balloons that I blew up earlier. Now, when I was inside, they were a wee bit bigger. They got a little bit smaller now that we've taken them outside because it's a little bit colder. And as you can imagine, what happens to particles when they get really cold is that they tend to shrink together. They don't move around so much, so they don't take up as much space. You can think about it as yourself if you went to the beach today. You wouldn't like lay out and enjoy the sun. You would huddle up and try to keep warm for as long as possible. Same thing with particles. All right, so let's see exactly what happens when I put this balloon into the liquid nitrogen. So if you can notice, the balloon is kind of shriveling up a little bit, losing some of the air that's inside, but it's not actually losing the air. All it's doing is the air molecules are getting much, much closer together. Is this tongue, stick that in there. They're getting much, much closer together, and actually, they're turning from a gas into a liquid. They get so close and move so little that they get to change states, right? They go from a gas to a liquid. So when we pull this out of here, you might be able to see a little bit of liquid in the bottom. It might be a little bit hard to see, but if we put it out there, you'll notice that the gas inside, the particles inside, start to take up more and more and more space, and they'll turn back into the size that they were before. They'll turn back into the regular gas particles that we originally put into the balloon. If we took it inside, it would get all that much bigger. So even outside in the snow, they're warming up to retake the shape of the balloon. All right, so that was with a gas. I want to try something with solids, because one of the kind of real applications that you can see every day in terms of this particle theory, when particles contract and expand, is in a bridge. Think about the Bridge of Nations, for instance. At either end, when you drive over, it goes clunk, clunk. Those are expansion joints. Those are metal pieces at both ends that allow the bridge to shrink a little and to expand a little without cracking or leaving spaces. Metals, just like everything else, their particles can contract and expand. And so what I have is a ring and a ball. And even though we're outside, the ball still fits through the ring. They're both at the same temperature, so they're both going to contract or expand at the same rate. But if I take one of them, if I take the ring and put it into the liquid nitrogen, it'll get much, much colder, and it should contract just like the balloon did. So we'll give that a few seconds to get really, really cold and really contract up nice. And then we'll try to put the ball through it. And actually, here's kind of an interesting side note. If you look inside the dewar, you'll notice that it's really starting to boil a lot. And that's because the metal that is pretty cold, I mean, it's outside at minus 27, it's not warm, is giving away its heat to the liquid. Things that are in contact with one another want to be the same temperature as one another. So the liquid nitrogen is trying to warm up, and the ring is trying to cool down so that their temperatures match. So I think we'll give that a try. And as you can see, the ring doesn't fit through the ball doesn't fit through the ring anymore, because the ring has contracted so much and got that much smaller. Now, if we give that a few seconds, don't lick it, that would be bad, right? The ball fits back through the ring because it'll expand up to its regular size, just like the balloon did. Alright, so we've been talking about particle theory. Things contract when they get really, really cold. One thing that doesn't exactly contract is water. Water, as we know, expands when it gets really, really cold. When it turns into ice, it takes up more space. That's why ice floats. And that's because water is kind of a special molecule. But what I wanted to do was show you a little demonstration. So, about 5 minutes ago, we stuck an onion inside the liquid nitrogen. Onions, mostly made up of water, so it will freeze and have a lot of ice inside of it. And we wanna see what's gonna happen. I'm just gonna throw it into the drawer there. So let's give that a try. All right, there's our onion. And as you can see, just like ice, it smashes to bits. I hope you enjoy this cool science post.